Good evening, hockey fans. Welcome to the Houston Fieldhouse. Finally, once again, for RPI Hockey here on RPI TV and ESPN, Perry Lascaris alongside Dan Fridgen, former RPI men's hockey coach. And we have, after 48 days without a home game, Fridge, we're here.
We're back.
There's a long shot in from the point. That was kind of creepy. Kicked away by Jack Watson. And the engineers are back out to center. Shane Seller trying to feed it back into the middle for Jacob Lee. And the puck goes into the corner. Lee's going to try and shoot it around back to the point. Louis Helson's there. Long shot over the top. Hit off a stick into the corner. Justin Adamo will whack it right back down low. It's a pretty big unit out there to start the game for RPI with Adamo, Seller, and Lee out there.
Yeah, that's a good size line.
RPI with an almost completely different lineup to who they had out there last, I keep trying to say Saturday, but it was Monday against St. Lawrence. They were short-handed due to the COVID protocols, but just about everybody back, Coach, all but three skaters are back in the lineup, or at least available.
Well, I'm sure they'll be raring to go here.
TJ Walsh off for Dubinsky. Zach Dubinsky flutters a shot high and wide. So engineers not afraid to be shooting once they cross into Yale territory so far, but so far off the mark. This is lobbed in the air, and Kyle Hallbauer is going to go back and pick it up for RPI. Picked up two assists on Monday against the Saints and a big 4-0 win. Now Surdy working himself down low, flicks a backhander. Not sure if it was a pass or a shot. Goes well wide, back out to center it comes. It's lobbed back in by Hallbauer.
Yeah, we had some snow while you were away on that Monday.
I didn't miss the snow. I was caught up in the North Carolina. Not caught up, I guess. It just took me a while to get home.
Once I got my snowboard board done, yeah. I went up and did Coach Weber's driveway for him because I knew he was in St. Lawrence. He only lives three houses up the road.
That's nice of you. Here's Tuur Linden. He was without a point last week and still leads the club with 20 over 25 games. He's the team's Hobie Baker nominee, senior captain.
Good two-way player.
Out of Lone Star, played for Lone Star Brahmas down in Texas. He's from Virginia, Great Falls. One of his fellow Virginians scored his first career goal on Monday. That was Reed Liebold, but he's not in the lineup this evening. Also, James McIsaac scored his first career goal, also on the lineup today.
Dan Wildfong, ex-Colgate grad, is the head coach for the Brahmas.
Puck played into the corner for Laka, and now Laka will work it out to center. Engineers taking on a Yale team that struggled record-wise, but recently they've been cutting down their goals against. They were leaking a number of goals earlier this season, but I don't think it's been five or six games since they've given up more than three. As Watson's out to play. Watson also had his best career college game on Monday against the Saints. 41 saves in the shutout, his first career college shutout. Adamo's going to tip this one deep and go in on the chase. Going after Michael Young, who's listed as the seventh D-man for the Bulldogs tonight. Puck all the way out to center ice. RPI leads the all-time series, but that series lead is shrinking. Yale has won seven in a row, which is the longest such winning streak for Yale in series history. So RPI trying to put an end to that. It includes a couple of playoff series sweeps in favor of Yale. So that doesn't help when you play in the twice in the regular season and in the playoffs and you don't have a lot of success.
Yep, those wins will add up quickly in those circumstances.
Surdy out to center. He gets tied up by the coach's son, Nicholas Elaine. And now a shot trickling wide. Lane's a sophomore, 7 points in 14 games. Loose in the slot. Walsh picks it up and flipped it over the top of the net. You want to try to hit the net from there. Nice move by Hallbauer to get free. He'll fire one towards goal. Dubinsky trying to jam it in as it might have hit him on the way. But so far, RPI is the team that's been able to set things up offensively in this matchup. We're not quite 5 minutes in.
Yeah, I think Dubinsky had his stick tied up by the defenseman, Lillibridge there. Couldn't get a handle on it.
Well, Hallbauer nearly lost it, then he iced it. Faceoff coming up in the RPI zone. Shots are 2-0. Yeah, I think that illustrates how this game has gone. RPI's had the better of possession, you could say. Their shots, when they've taken them, have been off target. They've missed the net. They've hit a couple of sticks, couple blocks maybe.
Yeah, that was a good opportunity for Walsh. He was in pretty tight, too, and just sailed it over top of the net.
Yeah. This number proves my point. Shots attempted are 5-2. Both of Yale's shots are on goal. None of the Engineers' five tries have found goaltender Nathan Reed, a sophomore from Madison, Wisconsin, who is 3-3-1 with a 2.69 goals against and a .903 save percentage. This will ring around. Simon Chelberg's there. Keep it alive. Kieran O'Hearn, who's now wearing number 2 after his number 25 uniform was lost. Right, Coach?
Yes, on the way to Milwaukee when they went out there to play in that tournament. Airline lost his bag.
Uh-oh, so there's a giveaway penalty coming up. No shot here, as it's going to be a hook or a slash. And an offensive zone penalty for Yale will put RPI in the power play here with 14:44 to go in the first.
Yeah, that was a pretty good whack.
I was like, that's how you force a turnover. No, unfortunately, it's not legal. Yeah, that's a slash. Or,
you know what? No,
that's why I thought
think
hook
that
right away.
That would have been a hook, yes.
Yeah, I thought it was a hook.
You kind of can open them.
Yeah. That's why I said hook, but we're going to go with what the ref says. Power play here for RPI. As RPI has set up its power play here. 14.9% on the season for RPI on the man advantage. 11 out of 74 scoring. As, it'll be Bulldogs playing a bit of keep away here. Now the puck goes out of play. Yale's penalty kill has not been good, under 80% on the season. They've given up 11 power play goals and 53 shorthanded chances. So maybe something this is RPI, something RPI can take advantage of.
Yeah, they just need to get in the zone and set it up. They haven't had that opportunity as of yet.
30 seconds gone on that power play. A center ice draw. Puck comes free. Backing up in his own zone is Lillibridge, captain there from Geneva, Illinois. 3 goals on the year from the blue line. Shelberg through the middle. Yale looks like they have RPI's breakout sniffed out, but Engineers improvise and get into the zone. Dubinsky plays it back to the point, but it's vacant. And Yale will change all 4 penalty killers. RPI will substitute as well.
Yeah, they're just looking like they're a little bit out of sync here.
It almost feels like first time back in your home rink in a game. I know you practice here, but it's been a while since the Engineers have actually played a game at this rink. And another giveaway is Bulldogs are reading this breakout very clearly here.
Yeah, they are.
They're just shadowing the trailing skater and forcing turnovers. Is nice play at the line to keep it in by Agnew. And a nifty pass between his own legs to find Lepinen. Otto Ville Lepinen was red hot before he was out due to COVID. Back in the lineup now. Down low for Lepinen. 4 points in his last 2 games. There's a shot blocked. Played into the corner by Adamo. And now work back to the blue line. Mashey pokes at it. Bulldogs trying to clear. Kept in by Mashey, who's not a defenseman. Just playing that left point. And power play is about to expire. So a good kill there by the Bulldogs. They made it difficult for the Engineers to enter the zone. And ultimately, when they did, didn't have a lot of time to get anything going. Here's John Beaton. Feeding it down low. He'll get back on it on the wall. Back to the point. Hallbauer quickly across for Baxter. He has some room to step into a shot, but it was closed down in a hurry. Nice job there by Justin Pearson, the senior.
Yeah, he took too long to let that shot go.
Yeah. He tried to gain a little bit too much ground there. He tried to get a little too close, and Pearson got across. High off the glass from Hallbauer. Settled down by Beaton through his own legs. There's Schreifels. Henri Schreifels trying to make a move. It's poked away. And towards the wall and moved out to center ice. Spin move Pearson flips it in deep. Stopped there by Watson. And now Baxter. He also missing last weekend. Flipped on goal. Played by Reed. Given away in the slot. Dubinsky a shot and a big time save by Reed there to keep this one scoreless.
Looks like they're going far stick side on the goaltender Reed.
Best chance of the game.
Reed.
Yeah. Best chance of the game for either team there. Yale looking to break out near side. Turned around, but turned over. Gamble goes backwards with it. Back to play, Lillibridge up the wall. Off a skate, now into RPI territory. Helsin slams it off the wall. Gamble right back in, but right onto the tape of Louis Helsin. Dallas, Texas native is Helsin, playing in his seventh game for RPI. Helsin again on it. He's double-teamed. Bulldogs come away with it. Played back to the point by Quinton Ong. Into the slot, slap back to the wall. Now Mashey has it. And he'll alleviate some pressure out to center ice. Lillibridge, long stretch pass is a good one. Fanning on the shot there, well defended by Agnew. And now Lapinen has it hop off his stick. It'll allow the Bulldogs to take over again. It's Dylan Herzog, the freshman from Auburn, Washington. Right back to center it goes. Played back into the zone. Lapinen trying to step around his man. He's closed off there by O'Hearn. Bulldogs looking to break out now. Riley Connors, a sophomore from Madison, Connecticut, will just clear it out as far as RPI's end of the ice, and the Engineers turn it around again, but it's quickly given away. Now a chance for a two-on-one for the Bulldogs. Walking in, a shot saved by Watson. Came off his line to close down the angle a bit. Made it an easier save. Still not an easy stop there in a two-on-one.
Not at all. He's got some good size to him.
So the best chance for Yale comes after Dubinsky gets open in the slot, and both goaltenders equal to the task, although that shot, just from our vantage point, didn't look like the best placement. Looked like Watson was able to get his body in front of it.
Yeah.
Another look at it there. Shots are 3-1. Yale, we're halfway through the first period. Engineers have attempted 8. RPI was very opportunistic against St. Lawrence on Monday.
Yeah, it seemed like that happened whenever they got an opportunity, they were able to capitalize.
They got a couple breakaways that didn't help, didn't hurt either. Both the first two goals they scored were off breaks into the zone. Yale so far has been much more responsible along the blue line. Adamo has his man pinched up against the boards and comes away with a puck. RPI numbers if they hurry here. Bulldogs are in the middle of a change. Sending it back to Adamo. He's trying to center, but he was tied up nicely by Connor Sullivan. Not an easy guy to tie up, Adamo, for RPI. Out of Arrers, France, 6'6", 250. Former Colonial from Robert Morris University.
Yeah, wasn't it McIsaac that got the first goal up against St.
He did, yes, on a breakaway, yeah. And then Reed Liebold did the same. Here's a shot by Seller over the top of the net. Laca trying to keep it alive and does. Nice play.
And it was both their first goals of the season.
And careers, right. Hulbauer's shot, that's blocked. Schreifel's off the bench, has to play it backwards as that puck left the zone. And now Helsin beaten. Hulbauer, good connection there. Little flip into the corner. Stolen away by Locke, a good read, trying to center it quickly for Beaton. That's broken up. Now John Beaton going after it. Beaton just one of two Engineers with multi-goal games this year. Scoring's been pretty well spread around as the last few weeks can attest to. Shane Seller picking up his fifth goal of the year against the Saints. There's a pad save. On a shot by Connors, a little turnaround. Might have caught another netminder off guard there, but Watson had his left pad along the ice to make the stop.
Yeah, it looks like he covers down low pretty well.
Flip deep by Young. Michael Young, a junior from Medford, Massachusetts, working it back to the point, but leaving his spot there. It's actually Kyle Johnson, the winger, who was covering there for Young. Didn't know quite where to be. To the line and out. Mason Klee on it now for RPI. He's the extra skater listed on the RPI line sheet tonight. out of Morrison, Colorado. This is O'Hearn, up the boards and out. Simon Shelbert, snap pass across for Walsh, on for Lappinen. He'll drive his way in on Ovile Lappinen out of Espoo, Finland. Lost an edge and went down. Shelbert keeps it alive, gets through to Lappinen, who still can't find the puck. And finally, Johnson moves it out for Stevens and dumps it in. Linden had it poked away. Flea just able to scrape that one around the forechecker there, and it'll hop out of play. 6:27 left in the first. Shots are 4-1 Yale. And we get, I believe, a media stoppage here and chance to talk things over here.
Yeah,
get the puck on net, maybe.
Klee was lucky on that when he was the last man back.
Yeah, he just barely got it off, huh?
Yeah, he turns that over and Yale's off to the races.
Engineers are home. It's a busy schedule coming up, Coach. You got Yale Brown this weekend. They go to Harvard on Tuesday. Then Mayor's Cup on Saturday, to Dartmouth the next Tuesday, and then on the road the following weekend to Princeton Quinnipiac.
Whoa.
That's a lot of hockey. Talk about a minor league schedule.
I remember back in the day when playing in the ECAC, there were a lot of games on Tuesdays and one game on the weekend.
Yeah.
And then as the ECAC broke off,
yeah,
you had the Ivy stay at ECAC, and most of the Boston schools go into Hockey East. That changed somewhat.
Halfway through the game, or just about, up in Potsdam, women's hockey, they actually scored first, and they are currently tied with number 7 Clarkson 1-1. So a good effort so far for the RPI women, who are being outshot 24-10, but if you're playing with the Golden Knights, you can play with anybody. That's one of the hottest teams in the country, and perennial power, 3-time national champion Clarkson. So it's good to see the RPA women, who didn't play last weekend due to COVID protocols, seemingly haven't missed too much of a beat. And it has to be a good sign if you can come out of a delay like that with some good play.
I'm sure they were just...
And speaking of good play, the Bulldogs are on the board. A great passing play in front of the net, and it's 1-0 in favor of the visitors here. Teddy Wooding, a sophomore, gets his fourth of the season. Look at this play. A little through-the-legs dangle from Donhauser.
Oh,
highlight reel goal there.
Yeah, he was in tight, too. Going to the net, got that on his backhand. Watching it, committed himself. I was going to say the women were probably just itching to go. And
I'm sure they were. Yeah, I guess you're rested a little more too then if you aren't playing. Yeah. So the Bulldogs go up 1-0 here, and we've seen it throughout the years. If nothing else from a Yale team, they're going to have some guys with some great individual skill, and that's what we saw there from Donhauser making the play. Now a shot right on from Carpentier as he was left alone to walk right into the middle of the right circle, and Jack Watson makes the save. It's been a while since he's seen one go past him, Watson, and after making the 41 stops on Monday. Now Herman tried to walk his way into the zone. That was broken up.
Yeah, Yale's attacking them as they've always been a team like that. They don't like you to get offensive zone.
There's a quick shot and a save. Yeah, I think that was Pearson.
You have to do soft dumps on an indirect and have cutters going into the zone, because they do a good job of standing up and holding up their own offensive blue line.
Shots are 7-1 Yale with 5:35 to go in the first. And after RPI had the better of play early on, they weren't able to generate much as far as shots on goal, which would illustrated by the stat there, but just they were the better team early. Yale's kind of pushed back here.
Yeah, it's somewhat strange for RPI to only have one shot this far into the first.
We saw them do that to Union way back in October, limiting the Dutchman to one shot in a period. Eventually 15 in a game. That's on goal from center by Sullivan. And now flipped ahead. Bulldogs play up the wall. Nice interception. Good read by Mason Clee. Tried to give it across the middle. Carried in by Mashey. He'll throw a shot that's blocked. In front, looking for Linden. And it'll work it behind the net. Mashey has his man tied up. Lepinen trying to play it down low for Linden. And now Lepinen trying to fight his way to the puck. Good battle there with Riley Connors. Now Linden, nice job to force it free, but Hallbauer had backed up to center. RPI has to touch up as Helsen dumps it in. Laka goes into a tussle there with O'Hearn, and the puck's back out to center again. Helsen takes a look, shot it in off the boot of Stevens. And now Ryan Stevens, sophomore from Duxbury, Massachusetts, shoots it up the wall. Son of a former NHLer, Kevin Stevens, we talked about, the Penguins team that broke my heart as a young North Stars fan.
Yeah. Yeah, he won the cup.
I'm not happy about that, yeah.
Won the cup in 91 and 92.
Yeah.
That's former BC Eagle.
Yeah, six-year-old me was not very happy with Kevin Stevens and that Pittsburgh Penguins team. Wrap back into the zone.
If I'm not mistaken, that was a team with Yager and
yes,
Ronnie Francis was Ronnie captain.
Yeah, that team was loaded. Barrasso. I think that was Barrasso time, wasn't it?
Yeah, Randy Gillen.
Yeah.
I played with him in Binghamton.
Helsen battling for it behind his own goal. Picked up by Adamo. Seller hands it off there. Moved along for Lee. Lee pulls up on the half wall. Trying to play it back to the point. Kept in by Seller momentarily. Now it's played ahead. One on two. Gamble pulls it back. Tried to take a shot, but that's shut all the way down by Agnew, who then ices the puck. 2:49 to go in the first. Still just one shot registered on goal for RPI. They've attempted more than the Bulldogs have, 11-10. Don't want to harp on it too much, but key to the game, I guess, is pucks on goal, pucks in goal. They've done a good job, RPI has, all year of limiting shots on goal against their net. So it's a bit of a surprise that Coach mentioned, also surprised that the Engineers haven't.
Well, that was one of the keys that Coach Smith talked about in your interview.
Yeah.
About four of them checking in all three zones.
Mm-hmm.
They needed to possess the puck.
Yeah.
They needed to score goals and defend hard.
They haven't given up too much as far as chances. In fact, that opportunity that turned into the goal was a great individual effort by the Bulldogs. You have to give them credit for that play. That wasn't really a breakdown per se. Now Dubinsky moves it in just onside, trying to throw it across the slot area. He's looking for Walsh, and it was broken up.
Yeah, unfortunate not getting a shot there on a 3-on-2.
Elaine takes a big hit from Herman. But does get the puck into the zone. Moved out by Agnew, sophomore from Oakville, Ontario. Now Walsh skates it ahead. 2 goals and 9 assists on the season for TJ Walsh. He picked up a nice assist on Monday against St. Lawrence when he set up Seller with a beautiful cross-ice pass. As they'll be worked up the wall here, Pearson just tips it into the zone. Chelberg trying to move it ahead quickly as the Bulldogs change. Linden flips it by Carmichael and leans on him. Good hit there to separate Carmichael from the puck. Now Linden's tied up. Mashey comes to dig it out. And it's Ryan Mashey working it back to the blue line. Sends it across for Helsen. He'll flip one towards goal. Blocked well by Ong. Into the corner. Now Linden gets shoved down and Ong will carry it out to center. Stood up by Helsen. We approach a minute to go in the first period. Puck into the RPI end. Ong was just still recovering there, but it was played by an RPI skater, so no offside. Now it's shot off the boards. Schreifels off his skate. Lillibridge He'll take a look. Throws it into the skates of his man Johnson, but he works it in deep. Rung around for Schreifels. Flip through center. Laka's going to beat out the icing here with 36 seconds to go in the period. Nearly stole it away. Puck is still loose. Laka battling for it. There's a fallen Yale defenseman. That was Young. Centering pass comes all the way through. They were looking for Schreifels. Laka back up top to Surdy. 21 to go in the period. Surdy a shot. Bouncing puck cleared back out. Surdy again. He'll step into one. Gets a tip save. Rebound Schreifels. Still loose side of the net. And it's cleared behind. Off the glass. Not out. Kept in by Surdy with six. And Johnson with two, and that'll do it for the period. A flurry at the end of the frame. Triples RPI shots in the period. Unfortunately, that only went from one to three. But good fight at the end of the period. RPI not quitting on the puck, even in the final minute. Weren't able to tie things up, but maybe a sign of what the engineers can build on heading into the second.
Well, what you saw there was RPI was moving their feet, getting to the puck first. And it started off with Laka winning that one-on-one battle in the corner, pushing it back to defense, going from low to high and making Yale spread out, getting some good couple of shots on goal there.
All right, we'll take a break here and be back with more RPI hockey here on RPI TV and ESPN. Your score after one period is the Yale Bulldogs 1 and the Engineers nothing. You're watching RPI Hockey. Second period of play about to get underway. 5-on-5 hockey. Yale and RPI, the Engineers, trying to gain ground here in the ECAC hockey standings. They come in at 5-5 in the league. Good for 15 points due to all regulation victories.
Only one power play that last period for RPI.
Yeah. As Jacob Lee's going to move this one in, take a shot that's blocked. And it's going to be a hand pass. 11 seconds in, we'll get a draw in the Yale end. Yeah, the Bulldogs currently sit tied for what I guess you could call last place, or tied for 10th place. Yale, Dartmouth, and Princeton all have 7 points. The total games played in the league is all out of whack. It usually is due to just the Ivies playing a different schedule than everybody else, and then you throw in COVID, and it seems like nobody's played the same amount of games, but you only win the ones that you play. Adamo's going to take a shot here, save, second chance, and another stop as it's kicked away. Two stops there by Reed.
That was quite the angle he took that last one from. He was almost in the corner.
Maybe the instructions were to just shoot the darn puck. I don't know.
after three shots in the first period.
That's going to hop out of play. It was deflected after it was played ahead by Rory Herman. Just to finish my point, RPI is 5 points out of fourth place, which is the last bye in ECAC hockey play. Just almost exclusively lead games the rest of the way. So there's plenty of time to make up ground, especially when you can get 3 points for a regulation win. Makes things kind of crazy.
Yeah. Well, league games with one exception next weekend. At the
right. Yeah, with the one exception being the Mayor's Cup, yeah, which is a 2 o'clock start. But a chance for RPI fans to see the Engineers play down at MVP Arena.
And the women are playing at 11 a.m.
11 a.m., yeah.
I couldn't imagine getting up at 7 and having a pregame meal at 8.
So coach is not a fan of playing at 11 a.m.
I mean.
In my position, I love it.
Play
every game at noon or 1 o'clock. I'm happy. Because you're not going to be done for another 2 hours after the game's over anyway.
Because you're usually here 2 hours before the game, which is 9 a.m.
Yep. I'm usually here in my office 2 hours after the game.
Yeah, you're I'm talking from the player's perspective.
Oh, yeah.
You're having your pregame at 8 a.m.
Yeah, for sure. That puck's out of play. 18:21 to go in the second.
Now I got all these things dancing in my head of what I have for brunch.
We got to settle down those dancing food items. Some danishes, maybe. Chipped into the zone by the Bulldogs. RPI will chase it down as Laurie Surdy. Another Espoo, Finland native. And it's turned over. Bulldogs trying to catch the Engineers there. That rung off the inside of the post. And a slap shot flutters wide. So an opportunity there for the Bulldogs on the giveaway. They can't convert.
Yeah, they went low stick side on Watson.
So back the other way comes RPI. Another giveaway, and RPI takes advantage. Tour Linden says, thank you very much. And he goes top corner for his 9th of the season. We're tied at 1. Another look at it.
Yeah, I don't even think Reed was ready. Well, yeah, he was ready, but.
It's tough to be ready for that when your defender throws it right down the middle.
Yeah.
That's a bad giveaway.
That is a bad giveaway.
And Tour Linden, you can tell by the celebration.
Yeah. He's
done it before.
Yes. He's done it before, and that was a really good shot by him.
So Linden picks up the tally. It's his team-leading 21st point on the year. And a big goal for RPI, which we talked about. They only had 3 shots in the first period. Now Stevens the other way. Breakaway. Stopped there by Watson. Goodness, with the glove.
Wow, what to the backhand. Take another look at it here.
Great glove save there by Watson.
He didn't even have any room in behind him. Remember that save at the end of this game. On a post right before that. Isn't that the way it happens, though?
Yeah. Quick shot and a save there on the left pad. by Reed. Now back come the Bulldogs. Young pulls it back, and that one rings the iron. That's two pipes, and now another shot that goes wide. Hammered wide off the stick of Gamble. It's thrown through the crease. RPI clears off the glass and out. Boy, what has gotten into these two teams after a rather uneventful first period?
All I know is Watson better be rubbing those posts between whistles.
Well, the one specifically to his right has been wrong twice in less than 2 minutes of game time. This will come off the glass and awkwardly in front of Watson, who lets it trickle into the corner. Kept in by O'Hearn. It'll ring around. Pearson lost it. Adamo has it. Lobs it out to an open wing. Claimed by O'Hearn. He'll go D to D with it. Thrown up the wall for Pearson. Into the middle. Carpentier centering pass off the stick of Elaine. Back to the point, O'Hearn. Quickly across. Wrist shot coming. Save Watson. He had a man right in front of him. Might have even been bumped by Carpentier, but he made the save anyway.
Yeah, Yale does a good job getting to the net after that shot. You have to make sure that you're covering up and not leaving any rebounds whatsoever. They're just sitting on the doorstep.
So 4 minutes into this second period, we've already had two pipes and a goal.
This is more like it, Perry.
Yeah, now Linden walking in again, drops it back nicely there. Leppinen a shot off the glove of Reed, but he kept it out. Good opportunity there for RPI. The chances are piling up in a hurry. Back to the point. Schellberg a drive, saved by Reed. And the rebound swept away by O'Hearn. Chipped out to center. Shot back in by Schellberg. RPI has to touch up, and then Linden takes a shot there.
I don't know if he didn't get hit with the puck.
The puck. He might have got hit with the puck earlier.
I think he did.
And he's going to get looked at here. Engineers can ill afford to lose Tour for a number of reasons, not the least of which is what he displayed earlier this period. He's scoring goals, his ninth of the season. Most on the team. He does it all, Fridge. He's good offensively and defensively. Made his name as a defensive center, a penalty killer as a sophomore, freshman. So he's really picked up his offensive game. I guess we only have a couple of years to look at, but his sophomore season he broke out scoring-wise.
And he's very, very responsible from a defensive perspective. And as you can see, he give him an opportunity offensively, and he'll take it. He'll bury it.
Faceoff coming up at neutral ice here. 15:04 to go in the second period. 1-1. RPI is pulled even here on a goal by Tour Linden. Ninth of the season. Surdy lifting it up the wall. Jacob Lee flips it into the zone. And now good pressure there by Adamo, forces the puck free at the point. Shot tipped on goal, but having enough time to read. The redirection was Reed, as Seller did exactly what he wanted to. He just was a little too far away from goal, and Reed was able to track the puck off his stick. That was a nice, nifty play there. Another look at it there. Just saw it all the way.
Yeah. Yeah, just RPI's put their defenseman down on the line for this faceoff and dropped Seller back.
Turning and shooting. It was deflected off the stick of Lee. Adamo moved in by Seller. Shane Seller along the wall. Nice job to stay on his feet, but he lost the puck in the end. Lillibridge ahead. 3-on-2 if they hurry. Downhauser across. Drop pass. One time blocked there by Hallbauer. And now he wants to skate the other way with Seller. Hallbauer across. Seller, man trailing, trying to find him at the flex behind the net. As Seller was looking for Lee. Helson will shoot it in. RPI looked like they were offside there. But goes uncalled, and we play on. Seller shooting it around. Walsh. Lost out there. It's flipped over the head of Chelberg. Yale wants to get a change. RPI retrieves the puck in their own end. Walsh shoots it in. O'Hearn takes a look, lifts it up the boards. No, it's blocked down. Dubinsky, stick handling, lost it to center. Pearson's got speed. Trying to get around Baxter, has a man in the middle, and it flies all the way through. He was looking for Ian Carpentier, the sophomore from Worcester. Sullivan shooting it in. Watson helps it around. Agnew on for Mashey. Mashey to Dubinsky. And Zach Dubinsky will shoot it in and peel off to get a change. Baxter on the pinch. Pearson has a loose stick to deal with. Finds Carpentier. Tries to make a move. Good play by Lampinen to keep those skates together and read the play and shoots it back in. Wrapped around by Sullivan, all the way out to center. Territorial advantage belonging to RPI right now. See if they can turn it into something. Dumped in, Lampinen played behind. Surdy on the pinch now, gets some help from Mashey. But Sullivan has it again for the Bulldogs, and he'll skate it ahead. Sullivan to the red line and did enough to get it deep. Surdy picks it up there. Tour Linden, little fake, works it ahead. Laka out of Bratislava, Slovakia, shoots it in before taking a big hit from Connors. Nice read by Beaton to fire it back in. Yale having trouble breaking out of their own zone thanks to this RPI forecheck. They can get this far. Now they get it deep, finally. Henry Wagner, sophomore from St. Louis, has a goal and assist on the year. Beaton, nice move there. Shifty move to get into the zone. Try to poke it around his man. Schreifels leans in on Herzog. Puck comes out towards the line. Well kept, well shielded by Laka. He'll try and turn the corner. Now he hands it off. Long shot from the point is blocked. And it caroms out to the near side. Swatted in by Laka. On further by Beaton. Now all Yale can do is flip to center again, and RPI will retrieve. Stretch pass here off of Adamo. Didn't really have a real plan with that, and now the Bulldogs turn it around at center. Johnson in, trying to walk around Helsin. Helsin does a nice job to wrap him up. Played back to the point, read by Seller. Shoots it off the boards and tries to chase it down. Young. Oh, just over the stick of Adamo, or he might have been in business. Now back come the Bulldogs. Yeah, it's Johnson. Go ahead.
There was nobody between him and the net there.
Just Stevens with a shot from the wall. Didn't have a lot on it, but it was kicked away by Watson. Now it's fired all the way through. Shots are 11-9 Bulldogs here as we near the halfway point of the second period. Taking a spill there was Rowan, and the Engineers get it deep. What have you seen from RPI here that you like, Fridge?
Well, you know what? They've got some flow going. It's been a long time since we've had a whistle, and they're just rolling the lines and keeping the pressure out, and each line is having a good shift.
Well, Agnew fanned on a pass, but gets some help from Baxter. Tried to stick handle through the middle. That doesn't work. As now Gamble played in deep. Agnew runs to the corner. It's kept in along the far wall by Wooding. Touch pass into Dubinsky. Good look. He finds Herman around a check. Goes down. Thought he was going to hand it off to Walsh there, but ends up losing it. And the Bulldogs played up the boards. Tipped into the zone. Race for it here. Wooding is going to try and get on it, but Helsin's the first one to it. Lepinen high off the boards and out to center and all the way down. Had a little bit too much mustard on that. Lockett trying to beat out the icing, and he can't. As O'Hearn is the first one down. Two minutes left up in Potsdam in regulation time. RPI Women's Hockey and Clarkson are tied at one, Coach. Gotta love it.
That's awesome.
Good shots are 36-14, but you can count on an RPI goalie, whether it be Lovisa Solander of the past or Amanda Rapato of the present. There's a quick shot and a save there by Watson. Kicked along by Lapinen, but defended by Sullivan. Back to the RPI
line. That's off, something they weren't doing in the first period.
All right, shots are,
I think they're pretty even.
I'm looking at the wrong game. I'm looking at Clarkson, which is now going to overtime up in Potsdam. I was like, 40-14 doesn't sound right. That was the women's game. 30-22 are the attempts in favor of RPI, and the shots are 12-12 on goal, which is a hockey even. Shot. Gonna close those Zamboni doors so we can play hockey again. Here we go. Apologies if we had any interruption or folks watching at home. Of course, it's the only way to take this one in. They're not allowing anyone to view this game live here at the Houston Fieldhouse currently. Hopefully that changes the next few weeks. But this weekend, no fans whatsoever. Dubinsky. He'll backhand it down low. If you don't like cold weather, though, it probably suits you fine. It's what, we're in single digits again, Coach?
Oh, it's a balmy 9 degrees Fahrenheit.
Is it 9?
Yeah.
Love that. Well, that hits LeBlanc, the referee.
Feels like 9 degrees in here, too.
Hopefully Brad's okay. Quick shot and a save there. My Hermit found himself in a good spot in that left circle. Rung around for Laka. Flipped into the near corner. Lillibridge tried to walk away with it. Again, the engineers pressure, and they're forcing just these short clears from Yale. Flipped ahead. Here's Laka. Turns it back to the blue line. Hands it off. Baxter a drive, and that one was headed wide all the way. But try to get something towards the net. Now it'll be gloved down by Anthony Baxter, playing in his 139th career college hockey game. You're going to see a lot of career game records getting broken around the country.
Oh, yeah, that's
right. With the extra year that guys have gotten, some of them who played last year.
Yeah.
Still doesn't matter. The NCAA grants an extra year, so you're going to have guys playing. You might see someone playing close to 200 games in their career, depending on how deep their team went into the NCAA tournament, right? Or
that's
conference
right.
Tournaments.
Yes.
I know the RPI record is 154 games, and that was Chase Palachik. I believe I want to say Palachik and Jeff Foss from the RPI team that went deep into postseason play in the early part of this decade. Of course, Baxter's games played are mostly at Lowell, so he won't factor in career-wise as far as RPI's career games are concerned, but you're going to see, like I said, around the country, there's going to be a lot of guys pushing 180 career games, which is just what's happening this COVID era. It's a lot of college hockey games. Sullivan's going to shoot this in. Watson stops it there. He's turned away 11-12 so far after stopping 41-41 on Monday. Adamo playing it ahead. Seller trying to get there. He got all spun around, and Sullivan comes away with it. For as much of the puck as RPI's had, the grade A chances haven't been too many to count here. And Neil trying to counter as that one is off a skate and into the corner. Well, you do want to turn that possession into something.
Yeah, you had Nicholas Elaine right in front of the net, wide open on that play. Just didn't get the puck to him.
RPI back in its own end. Seller to center, flipping it in deep. Carpentier. Well read there by Shelberg off the stick of Mashey. Picked up. Oh, Beaton was about to walk in. But O'Hearn by the end of his stick, was able to break it up. Now beaten again, trying to walk it in front. He's knocked down there, might have run into the post. Good hit by Schreifels along the wall, lobbed high in the air out to center. Kind of like the way John Beaton drives the net like that.
I think he caught a piece of the goaltender as well, by the way he that Watson reacted.
To center ice it goes. Touch pass there. Off the stick of Johnson. Yale has to start over again in its own end. They move it ahead. Wooding stolen away. Chelberg. Walsh. Off the glass to center ice. Chopped at by Dubinsky all the way down. They're going to wave off the icing. Graham Lillibridge. Playing in his 73rd career game as a senior. Of course, the Ivies, along with RPI, didn't play at all last year. Into the middle. That comes all the way through. Dubinsky will track it down. Out of Highland Park, Illinois, is Zach Dubinsky. Went back to play some junior hockey in the season RPI didn't play for the Omaha Lancers as Hullbauer lost an edge but does get the puck in deep. Bulldogs to center. Donhauser shot one off the skate of Laka, then tussles with him after the fact. RPI four across as they hit the blue line here. Herman runs out of room, just backhands it down low. Nice play. Dubinsky tried to feed it on further, but that's broken up. Wooding. Just plays it in, and Yale will change. Pass to center ice, won by Linden. Almost turned into a 50-50 puck there, but now Agnew will backhand it deep. Lobbed around by the goaltender Reed. That's broken up in the corner.
RPI is doing a much better job this period of getting the puck deep in the zone. They tried carrying it across in the first period, but they weren't getting any penetration.
Stolen away there by O'Hearn. He'll play it ahead off of Wagner. Still loose in the slot. To a knee went Connors. He'll fire one on goal. Another shot and a save, and it trickles into the net. Riley Connors. The sophomore from Madison, Connecticut, I believe was the one who got the last touch. It was kind of a busted play. But the Bulldogs take advantage with 53 seconds left in the period.
It was. I don't know if he put that in off. Oh, there, he shoved it just right there.
It was a second effort there. Yeah, it was Wagner who took the first shot that Watson saved. And it was just a matter of battling in front of the net, and the Engineers lost that battle.
Well, they're outnumbering them here right now.
Baxter was the only D-man in front.
Three, but nobody's tying up sticks.
Lee shoots it in. Adamo throws a hit. We got a net off?
No, helmet off.
Oh, okay.
He lost his head.
Carpentier, yeah, okay.
So I think he has to change. They have to.
It's like football. You got to take a playoff. Yep. 44 seconds to go in the second. Yale has retaken the lead 2-1 here. Cleanly won back to Chelberg. A shot deflected on goal. Save made, and the rebound's going to be covered up.
Ooh, that was loose.
Yeah.
That
Chelberg
was loose.
Got that one to the net like you want to.
Yep. Did a little abracadabra with the feet. Faked right, went left. Right here. That puck is loose.
Yeah, Reed stopped it, but then the rebound popped a little further away than he wanted to and had to pounce on it again. Adamo shielding, turning and shooting. It's blocked and flipped down ice. This is going to be icing on Yale. 24.3 seconds to go. Almost a Matador style of game here from the Bulldogs. They took a lot of pressure from RPI most of this period and ended up scoring the goal-ahead goal late. Engineers were just ramming the puck into the zone and possessing. Couldn't add on. Here's a shot tipped wide. Adamo might have got a piece of that.
That was a third straight faceoff. Elaine lost it to Lee.
Lee on it again. RPI's done a real good job on the draw so far. Shot in the pad, save. Lifted out to center with one, and that'll do it for the second. Yale retakes the lead after RPI tied it up earlier in the period. Tour Linden scoring at 2:15, but it was Nicholas Elaine they're currently crediting with the goal. I think it was Connors. We'll take a look at that and see if it needed a change there. But anyway, regardless of who scored it, it's Yale's goal, and they lead 2-1 after two.
And RPI picked up some shots in that period, getting basically, 13 shots? They only had three at the end of one. Now they got 16.
And how about the RPI women, Coach? Well, before we go to break here, they win in overtime in Potsdam, 2-1.
That's awesome.
Taylor Larson scores the winning goal, not a minute into extra hockey up there. So a huge, huge 2 points for RPI women's hockey on the road at Clarkson. What a win. Congratulations to Coach Vines. And Shelby Perry is their new assistant coach. That's their first game she's ever been on the bench for.
Really?
Former Colgate Raider.
Yeah.
They just finished the hiring process, I guess, a week or so ago. This is her first game on the bench, and seems like she's a keeper there because RPI picks up the win in her first game at a place that is extremely difficult to win for anyone.
And if anybody would know how to play Clarkson, she would, based
that's
on
true.
How many times
Colgate and Clarkson play. They play the national title game, if
that's
I remember right.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll be back with the third period here where RPI men's hockey trails Yale 2-1. You're watching RPI Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN. Third period about to get underway here at the Houston Fieldhouse in a chilly Troy, New York. Perry Lascaris and Dan Frigin here. RPI down a goal here to the Bulldogs, and seems like it's anyone's game still with this deficit available for the taking here if they can, the Engineers can come out like they did in that second period.
Yeah, late goal. You don't ever want to give those up. So it seemed like RPI really came to life in that second period. Got their forecheck going, which allowed them some scoring opportunities.
Shots through two are 16-14 RPI. Faceoffs are 17-13 Engineers. There's only been one power play in the game. It was RPI's. They did not score. This will play 5-on-5 hockey to start the third. It's a home weekend here for RPI where they hope to pick up some ground in the ECAC hockey standings, but right now trail by one. Here we go. Jacob Lee in deep. Pulls up behind the goal, trying to center. It's swept away from him by Lillibridge. And now over to get it is Gamble. Briggs Gamble ahead. Bouncing puck at center, played by Lee off of the defenseman. It hit Carmichael up high, but goes into the corner. Wooding. Nice find as Gamble with speed into the RPI zone. 2-on-2, poked into the corner. Louis Helson trying to get there, and he's wrapped up with Downhauser. Bit of a tough handle there, but a nice play by Seller. Tough pass in on his feet, but he's able to deal with it. Now the Bulldogs moving into the zone. Carpentier into the zone! A shot and he scores! A delayed reaction. I got screened a bit from where I'm sitting, or standing.
It looked like it went through him. And
yeah.
I don't know if even Watson saw that shot, because by the way he played it, it looked like he was just coming out and making himself big. Take a look at it. He has no idea where that
puck. It just trickled through.
Yeah, he doesn't know where it is.
It wasn't clean. That's what the delayed reaction was, what confused me.
Yeah, yeah.
From everybody. 1 minute into the third, it's Carpentier. Gives Yale a 3-1 lead. Goal for Ian Carpentier is his third of the season. This will hop out of play. It's certainly not what the Engineers wanted. Start the third, but at the same time, a lot of time left here. As the Bulldogs win the draw all the way back to their own goaltender. Reed will hand it off. That's nearly given away. Now it was given away by Walsh, who backhanded in. Dubinsky gets pinned against the wall there by O'Hearn. Surdy pinches along the wall. Right back in it goes. Sullivan to play. And it's given away again. Dubinsky circles. Poked off his stick.
Yale does that a lot, where they try to make that cross-ice pass and they give it to an RPI player right in the middle. That's how Linden scored his goal.
Yeah, they seem to be playing very solid defense, but then it's just that when they get the puck, it's almost to their most vulnerable for some reason. But, you're right. Yale trying to extend an already school record winning streak against RPI. 7 in a row, the Bulldogs have beaten the Engineers. And it doesn't seem to matter how well the Bulldogs are playing, although over recent years they've been one of the top teams in the league. So far not the case here in 21-22, although it seems like Cornell is the only Ivy League team that's not hurting a little bit this year.
Yeah, Cornell is Cornell.
Although, tonight,
what
did you show me? Are they still losing to Princeton?
Yeah, they were losing 3-1.
This is going to be icing, I think. 7:24 to go. 17:24 to go in the third. 3-1 Yale on top here.
So why don't I give you some out-of-town scores and beat half of the ECAC? Start of the third period, Quinnipiac's up 2-1 on Colgate. Start of the third period, Princeton's up 3-1 on Cornell. Clarkson and Dartmouth are tied midway through the second. And Union is up 2-1. I don't think this is right. It says 18:54 left in the second period.
Yeah, that's got to be close to the third by now.
Yeah.
Puck out to center. Baxter back to get it. Grad student out of Oakville, Ontario. Lost it along the boards. He was being pressured there by Donhauser, but now connects to Mashey. Cross-corner dump in. Schreifel's the first one to it. Henri Schreifel's behind for Beaton. Tried to walk away without the puck. Now Baxter will pinch, and it's kicked out of the zone by Donhauser and all the way down. Dubinsky. Baxter. Agnew. Down the middle off the stick of Schreifels. Elaine has it. And now moved into the zone. Centering pass, broken up. Baxter got in the way. Back to the point, Carmichael. Some room at the far point. Lillibridge walking in, takes a shot. That one might have caught the stick of Walsh on the way through as it went out of play. 16:15 to play. And Yale with an opportunity there, working the puck neatly around the offensive zone. And good block, however, by Walsh.
RPI's got to get back to what they were doing in the second period, getting that puck in behind the defense of Yale and putting some pressure on them. Hopefully look for another turnover.
Leppin in cross ice, swatted in by Linden. Sullivan will take a look. Lobs it high in the air, gloved down by Holbauer. Kyle picked up two assists on Monday, assists 2 and 3 on the year. Good to see him rewarded. When the RPI needed him, engineers were basically down to 5 healthy defensemen by the end of the weekend. With Jake Johnson going down, who's been arguably their best defenseman at both ends of the ice this year.
Yeah, he's real good offensively and defensively. You're right.
There's a shot that comes all the way through. Linden. He was eating a lot of minutes, especially even the Clarkson game last weekend where RPI fell 5-0. As that one's jammed in on goal, and Watson lost sight of that for a second. Of course, you lose Johnson in that Clarkson game, and made the rest of the weekend all that more difficult, which makes that Monday win all that more impressive. They're able to do so without Jake Johnson. But now with the rest of the lineup back, essentially, they have to figure out a way to continue to play well defensively and move the puck up the ice without Jake. 14:30 to go in this third period. 3-1 Yale on top. RPI is out shooting the Bulldogs 16-15. Talk all the time, Fridge, about opportunistic offense, and that's what Yale's been tonight. They've also hit the post a couple of times. They really haven't had the puck a lot.
Well, they've done two things that, as an opposition team,
yeah,
RPI in this case, that you don't want to do, and that's, RPI doesn't want you to score late in the period or early in the period. Which
both, yeah.
Yeah.
Right about that. This is cleared out by the Bulldogs, and I think it'll be icing. He wasn't trying to. Gamble was trying to play that softly down the ice, but that one skittered all the way down. So icing will force those same skaters for the Bulldogs to stay on here.
RPI needs to get a good shift here. Here's another look at it.
Got bodies in front there, just never got it through.
Yeah.
And I think Yale's going to take a timeout here. RPI is back in action tomorrow night. The Brown Bears come to town. They're over in Schenectady right now. Do we have a score from that game? I guess it was.
Yeah, it was 2-1 for
2-1
Union.
2-1 after two.
Yeah.
So that one really still up in the air.
There's a team that's always been a tough matchup for RPI.
RPI basketball looks like it's on its way to its first loss of the year. They're down by 17 in the first half to Vassar. Great story there. RPI men's basketball unbeaten in the league. I think they're 11-1 overall. They're number 23 in the country, but they're getting a solid test. Of course, they're not able to play in their home arena. They're playing over at the UHY Center, which is over in Loudonville on the Siena campus, because they don't have access to ECAV today. They're home on Sunday against Skidmore. But the big news tonight, the big hockey news in ECAC hockey, RPI hockey, RPI women pulling off the victory up in Potsdam against number 7 Clarkson, 2-1. Taylor Larson scoring the game-winning goal in the first minute of OT. A nice 3-on-1. Rosh took a pass from Mara Wagner, who's been the driving force at what's made this RPI women's team such a solid group this year. Really a whole collective effort, of course. This is a pad save made by Watson. And it'll be cleared out to center there by Herman. Here's Schreifels. Pulls up along the wall. Beaton's there. Beaton around the net. Back up top. Hallbauer wrists it wide. I'm not sure that Reed saw that one all that well, or maybe just saw how far wide it was.
Yeah, and he
didn't react.
He moved from right to left and then shot it back to the right.
Here's Herman over skates. And now moved ahead by Sullivan, dumping to the far corner. Surdy. Hallbauer. Now Laurie Surdy to center, given away there. It was read by Herzog, and the D-man will move it in. To the back post, throwing it in front. It's swatted away as Hallbauer knocked it off the line. He was standing in behind his goalie, and he made a real nice play there.
Yeah, the Yale player is trying to put it off the pad of Watson.
And now Laka tried to leave it for Linden, but he didn't give a lot of room for him. Now stolen away, Linden in front. Lampinen, a shot and a save. Rebound, Lampinen. Turn to jam it home, and it's swept out. How did that not go? Another jam try, and they score. Backdoor feed to Linden. And this line didn't give up, and they were rewarded, pulling RPI back within a goal. It was the second of the night for Linden, 10th of the year.
Well, what happened was Reed lost his stick, and the defenseman for Yale tried to give him his stick, and they forgot about Linden, Tor Linden, right at the side of the net. Take a look at this. Look at it. He grabs the stick, moves it out of the way for Tor, and the guy was able to make the
Lampinen
was able to make that pass.
Yeah, you can't give Lampinen that many options, and he's one of the best passers in all of college hockey, and that is a good example of that. They're going to look at this. Now, this is funny because I think they might be reviewing the previous play for a goal.
Yes.
Which is almost a moot point.
Yeah.
Could they give RPI two goals there? I don't think so, right?
No. You know what? I think maybe this one down here.
Yeah, it could be. Yeah.
Maybe the Yale one that was on the line.
That looked pretty clear too.
Because I don't think this was goaltender interference.
No.
At all.
No, which is why I'm wondering what they're looking at. Because I don't know the ruling on that, right? Like, so say RPI the first play for RPI goes in the net, right?
Yeah.
And Yale goes down and scores.
Yeah.
Could they award both goals?
No, I don't think so. I think they.
No. You're saying no.
No, I'm thinking that if they rule that RPI scores the goal, then that negates anything that's happened after that. It would seem, because had they blown it there, then that wouldn't have happened.
I have to read into the rules a little bit more. I'm sure I'm going to be corrected online for this, but if the initial RPI play that was waved off as no goal was continued on and Yale went down and scored, you're saying that Yale goal wouldn't have counted if they went back and looked and saw RPI scored?
Yes, exactly. Because what
there's the initial. This is looking at here. It's flopping around. That,
yeah.
That's awfully close.
That is.
I'm not sure if they have a better angle. That I think they might have a top-down view.
Yeah,
they do have a top-down view over there.
And
we don't have that anymore.
And what they'd have to do, They would have to reset the clock.
Oh, boy, that's really close. I don't think it's in. And Linden, it would be Linden's goal either way, either the one he scored afterwards or the one
right.
he had scored previously. So,
yeah.
I think they're saying nothing of that.
Nope.
Okay. So
yeah, it would go back to the original goal that was scored first, and then the clock would go back to what that time was.
Okay. I was just trying to come up with a scenario where it could be a double goal, but that's coach says no dice there. It was a fun theory. Anyway,
I just can't believe that they would concentrate more on the goaltender's stick,
yeah,
and not
the puck
cover the RPI players,
yeah,
yeah. While Linden and then
yeah.
Otto makes a play.
Otto Viele with a real nice pass to set up his captain and line mate. Those two have been worked together for a number of years, both seniors now. They didn't have junior years. It's a big hit on Baxter by Elaine. Laka goes hard into the sideboards. Linden out there looking for the hat trick. Good defensive play as it's broken up by Agnew. Now he'll pick it up. 3-2 is the Yale lead. 11:23 to go. Linden back for Lepinen. Across in front and trying to jam it in was Laka. Everybody's down and out, including the goalie, who looks to be shaken up on the play. As Laka was going to the net, I think he got run into by Sullivan.
Looks like he hurt his knee.
Yeah. Let's take another look at this. Lepinen throws it to the net. Laka's trying to jam it. Yeah, Sullivan goes flying into his own netminder.
Oh.
Yeah, Sullivan landed.
He was down. He had his pad down.
Yeah. He looks like he twisted it. Well, we're not going to speculate anymore there. 11:13 to go in this period. And it's good to see Reed back on his feet. And he looks to be all right. Good to see that.
Yep.
Yeah, it was an awkward-looking collision between Laka, Sullivan, and Reed.
Yeah, it was.
Lapinen made the right play. You throw that puck to the net front and see if anything knocks it in, whether it be your teammate or the defenseman Sullivan or the goalie himself. But Reed able to stand strong and keep the puck out.
It's always a good play to throw that puck at the net because you never know what's going to happen. Forces a goaltender to play it.
So we'll draw things up here to the right of the netminder, Reed. Baxter will carry it down low. Spins it back. Lee across. Agnew a shot. That hit skates. Never got to goal. Knocked down by Agnew. Played down the middle. Carried on by Wooding. He'll take a shot blocked there by Baxter. Shots are 19-17 Engineers. They trail by one. Adamo plays it ahead. Swept on by Seller. Lillibridge, center ice. Adamo's there. Draws a crowd. Find Mashey. Mashey a shot. Blocker save. Might have caught the pad of Reed. Dubinsky across. One-timer and a glove stop by Reed. He didn't hold it. Up the boards from Kyle Johnson to center. Mashey trying to find it in some skates. There's three Bulldogs over there. Stevens is the one who comes away with it. Lillibridge. Dubinsky backtracking in his own end. Shakes one forechecker. Klee carries it in. Swept away from danger by Tabakant. And Brandon Tabakant will have to try and find it again. It's actually Sullivan behind his own goal. Sullivan nearly ran into trouble. Lepinen pestering him. Ong, no. Shot ahead. Now that's broken up at center ice. Back in comes Laka. Lepinen spins to create some room. Hallbauer. Wrist shot coming and a blocker save. And a whistle here as they're going to get Laka away from the puck.
I think they're going to take both of them.
We're going to get Sullivan and Laka?
Yep, 4-on-4.
Okay. So Laka and Sullivan, they got tangled up in front of the net. They're both going to go off here.
I don't know if you've noticed, but those two have been sparring all game.
Yeah, they were the two that went into the goalie, too.
Yep.
Yep. Yeah. Sullivan tried to act like he was doing nothing wrong. Acting surprised. Okay.
That halo above his
head. Are they going to look at something?
No, they're cleaning the ice.
Oh, yeah. 9:02 to go, so it's a cross check on Laka.
He's got a hold in the stick or something. Holding.
.852 to go in regulation. RPI down by a goal. Simon Kjellberg's going to shoot one across, and it's kicked away. And now Yale will start the breakout from behind the net. Given room to walk in, and he scores.
Wow.
Top shelf, Ian Carpentier with his second of the game and fourth of the year.
Wow, what a shot. Did he go short side on that?
Yeah, that puck is stuck in the goal. Wow.
I can't believe the amount of room that he had to walk in and take that shot. Hallbauer was giving him that outside.
Goodness gracious, what a shot. He did go short side, Coach.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Wow.
Carpentier with a huge goal to make it a two-goal advantage again for the visiting Bulldogs.
That's pretty impressive, that shot. A lot of ice out there in this 4-on-4 hockey.
He had two goals in 11 games before tonight. So RPI down by a couple again. Agnew. Fanning on the pass was Lepinen. And now Surdy driving his way in, trying to make a move. Linden looking for the backdoor cut of Agnew. And the pass deflects up out of play.
Tour was all teed up there waiting for that pass across, but didn't quite get to him. A RPI's got their work cut out for them here with 7:44 left.
Adamo just trying to force that thing forward, and he got to the bottom of the circle, but that's all. Young on the stick handle. Bulldogs moving into the zone. Young back on it. Back to the point now.
Has there been a game this year where RPI hasn't taken a penalty? Because up until that point, they didn't have one.
Not this year. I've looked into this before. Here's Chelberg trying to drive the net, looking for the wrap. Nope. Pops out to the line and out of the zone. Adamo. Young just bounces off of him. I think he realized too late that he shouldn't try to throw this body check, but he ended up following through on it, and I'm sure he regretted it.
Adamo just leaned into the backside a little bit.
Out to center it goes. Carmichael driving it out in front, scrambling across to hit the post again, and it's cleared out by Baxter. That's the third time that Yale has hit the iron tonight.
Wow. So I would assume that Coach Smith is going to take a timeout because the guys look like they're a little on the gas side.
Yeah, we'll see. I think he's going to wait till the last minute if he's going to do it.
No,
yeah, that puck was...
He might need one.
And that was Ange who hit the iron that time on his backhand, went right through. Yeah, no timeout.
No. He may need it later on.
Yeah. Baxter. Good connection to center Lee. Going to get it deep, and RPI can get its change now. Partially at least. Shot in there by Pearson. Helson gets pinned up. Now carried ahead by Mashey. Runs into their linesman, Dubinsky. He gets tripped up, taken down.
Yeah, there's a hook.
Hooking call coming up on the Bulldogs. And RPI is going to go on the power play or a trip. Either way, the Engineers are going on the power play for the second time tonight and in a big spot in this game with only 5:54 to go.
It's Mr. Elaine going to the box. Son of 15th year head coach Keith Elaine.
I'm not sure what that puck drop was, but it wasn't near the circle or the dot, so I think they have to do that again.
Yeah, I think the players knocked it out of his hands.
Connors and Linden on the draw. Cleanly won back by Tour Linden. Back to Mashey, who's playing on the left point here on this power play. Second of the game for RPI. Lapinen feeding it down low and fanning on it was Linden, and it hops out of play.
Wow. It'll be interesting to see if RPI made any adjustments to their breakout based on that first period where Yale had them pretty much knew what they were going to be doing.
So Linden had a hat trick on his tape there if he could have just settled down that pass, but Zeppelin. Lapinen zipped it on him. Bouncing in the slot, Connors swats it out of the zone. Watson. Minute and a half to go on the power play. Lapinen. Rung in by Linden. Adamo waits for it, leaves it for Lapinen. Adamo backhands it back around to the point. Agnew, a wrist shot over the top. Tour Linden trying to go behind the net with it, and somehow it's grabbed by Reed.
Looks like RPI did make an adjustment on that breakout.
I think they scrapped that drop-off play if the Bulldogs were going to cover it. Face off again. Engineers win it. Chelberg. Laka. Slap shot. Well wide. Karam's off the end wall. Back down low past Walsh. Lillibridge a clear. Gets the job done. Hey, Simon Chelbert hands it off to Surdy. Drops it back to Walsh. Engineers hit the line a little bit of speed this time. Dubinsky trying to lay it back to the point, but Chelbert was all the way over centrally. Couldn't handle that. Now he's tripped up on the way in. 35 seconds to go on the RPI power play. Surdy is going to try and carry this one in, but the Engineers are offside this time.
Yeah. Yale's being too strong, well, playing real strong with their offensive blue line. RPI is going to have to chip in behind and get some cutters going because they're finding a tough time carrying that puck across that blue line.
Now Baxter's giving some instructions to Watson. I'm sure that's to when he's supposed to come off, which apparently is soon if they're talking about it now. 4:15 to go. Chipped into the zone and over the glass. So RPI 0 for 2 on the power play. They're still out shooting the Bulldogs 23 to 19. RPI 5-4-2 this year when they outshoot the opposition. They're going to have some work to do here if they're going to keep that going. Hallbauer. Beaten, carrying it. 5-on-5 hockey here. As that one eludes Schreifels. Gamble to center. Hallbauer just chops it off the boards. Kicked at by Schreifels. Couldn't corral it. Now it's played in by Pearson, who'll chase. Hallbauer leaves it off for Baxter. Given away. Baxter doing his best to try and win it back. Thrown through Pearson, who didn't see the pass initially. And now Carpentier. Lee. Nice job to avoid Carpentier and get it deep. RPI gets the change. Tour Linden just off the bench. Trying to feed it across. Play's broken up. And now Pearson will skate it to center. Takes a hit. Chelbert lapping it. Trying to settle down a rolling puck. Net is empty here.
There goes Watson.
Extra attacker on for RPI. With 2:47 to go. Schellberg has it hop off his stick and out to center. Now Linden. Laka moves it in. Carmichael up the boards. Broken up by Linden. Played back to the point. Schellberg. Far point Agnew, back to Chelbert, lapping it, feeding it down low, and a pad stop is made by Reed.
Good shot, a lot of traffic.
Another shot for the wall, they score! Otto Vile lapping it, makes it a 4-3 game, his seventh of the year. Bad angle shot from the wall, and I'm sure Reed's going to want that one back. I don't know if he didn't see it coming or what, but he...
He looked awkward when he was playing that.
He got caught for sure. And when you're down two like that and you extra attacker, get the puck to the net, and that's what Lepinen did.
Yep, that's all you have to do.
Oh, wow, how did that squeak through?
I have no idea.
I'm not sure. Laka might have touched it too. I don't know. They're going to have to look at that again. So back to the net goes Watson. Now he heads off again. Kepton at the line. Baxter. Adamo down low. 2 minutes to go here in regulation. Engineers back to within a goal. On the tally by, we think, is Lapinen. But like I said, Laka's stick was in the vicinity. Played back to the point. Nice job by Hallbauer to handle it as it was partially disrupted. Now Walsh shielding. Lost the puck. Hallbauer keeps it in. Mashey takes a look. Fires a shot, hit a shin pad, and the puck's out to center, but Lillibridge is clearly shaken up on the play. Walsh flipping it ahead for Adamo, and it's not cleared. Good play at the line by Walsh. Yale backhands it out of the zone, over the head, now a race for it. And they score into the empty net, and it's a hat trick for Ian Carpentier. And I'm not sure anyone was expecting that when this game started. He came, like I said, he came into this game with just two goals on the season. He has three tonight and it's 5-3 Bulldogs.
Well, what happened was they got it out into the neutral zone and Carpentier had a head of steam.
Yeah, when you're on a hat trick, I think you skate faster. I think it's
proven.
The analytics people can prove that. So back to the bench goes Watson. 1 minute to go. RPI back down by two. This will be wrapped around. Gloved at by the Bulldogs to the line. It hops over the stick at Chelberger. Now RPI has to touch up. All six of them do. Linden shoots it in. Wrapped to the boards. Pearson can't clear. Lapinen in for Agnew. Up top, Chelberg. Hot pass to handle, but he's able to track it down.
Yeah, that was just out of his wheelhouse.
And given away at the blue line. Empty netter number two, no. And icing against the Bulldogs with 19.2 left. Six skaters out there for RPI, trying to pull another one back here. As time winds down, Hallbauer walks his way in, shot and a save, rebound put wide. It'll be picked up by Walsh, 10 seconds to go. Backdoor pass comes all the way through, looking for Mashey. It's chopped at but not cleared. Hallbauer, another shot through traffic with three. In front of Damo, he flips it wide through his own legs. And that's going to do it, as now Dubinsky needs to be separated from couple of Bulldogs behind the goal. 5-3 your final here as Yale comes in and picks up a big road win as they try to climb their way out of the basement of the league. RPI falling here despite outshooting the Bulldogs 26-20, outdrawing them 29-22. You know, power plays, special teams wasn't really a factor here. RPI with two power play chances. The Bulldogs didn't have any due to the the matching penalties that happened there, the coincidental minors in this game. So, Coach, tough one for RPI to swallow as they thought they were playing pretty good hockey. They're coming off of an emotional win against St. Lawrence on Monday where they didn't have half their team or thereabouts as far as the roster. They get everybody back here, and it seemed to me maybe a little bit rusty playing together again for the first time, but we'll see if they're able to bounce back tomorrow.
Yeah, I thought so in the first period, but then I thought they really picked it up in the second. And, the backbreaker was the late goal in the second period and the early goal in the third period. They never gave up. They kept clawing back. But, I mean, credit Carpentier. He comes out and has a career game.
For sure.
With a hat trick, and that's the difference of the contest.
Sophomore from Worcester, Mass., former junior Bruin, Ian Carpentier, three goals in the game to lead this Yale Bulldogs attack. That'll do it for us here at the Houston Fieldhouse. You can check out tomorrow night's game right here on RPI TV or ESPN Plus, wherever you watch your UCAC hockey or RPI hockey. We thank you once again from all of our RPI TV crew here at the rink. And the coach, Dan Fridge, and I'm Perry Lascaris. We thank you once again for watching tonight's game. Final score was the Yale Bulldogs 5 and the Engineers 3. You're watching RPI Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN.